Canada is known to have one of the safest banking systems in the world. In British Columbia, the main types of financial institutions are banks and credit unions. Banking is a term used to describe financial activities conducted at any of these institutions. Banks are for-profit businesses, while credit unions are member-owned cooperatives in which members have a vote in how their institution is run. You'll want to compare different account types, services, and costs. You'll probably be banking with this institution for a long time, so it makes sense to find one that you're happy with. There's a comparison tool on the Canadian government's Financial Consumer Agency's website that identifies services and fees for many popular institutions. Open a local bank account soon after moving to BC. The bank will want you to present two pieces of identification or ID to open an account. A SIM card, a BC driver's license, or a permanent resident card are all acceptable forms of identification. See our other videos if you don't yet have a SIM card. Checking accounts allow you to write personal checks, which are debited against your account. These accounts usually do not pay interest and either charge a fee per transaction or ask you to keep a certain amount of money in the account. Savings accounts are intended to help you save and can pay interest on your money if you keep a certain amount in the account. Most institutions provide some kind of combination account. Many financial institutions offer online banking as part of your standard account, allowing you to do your banking 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Your financial institution can also provide internet banking and bill payment, foreign exchange services, wire transfers, credit cards, home mortgages or loans, retirement planning, and investment advice. If you're new to Canada, you'll want to start building up a Canadian credit rating. There are two credit agencies in Canada. In order to qualify for a credit card or other types of consumer loans, you'll need to prove you have a good financial record, your credit rating. Your credit rating or credit history is not about how much money you have. Instead, it's focused on whether you pay your bills on time and if you have a reasonable amount of debt. You can check your credit history by contacting either company. Checking your credit history will enable you to ensure that all the information on your record is accurate. Good credit is important for several reasons. Landlords will often do a credit check to make sure you have a good credit rating before deciding to rent to you. Having a good credit rating will also make it more likely you will get approval for other types of loans or credit cards. Now you're ready to bank in BC. When you open a bank account at a financial institution, either a bank or a credit union, you'll be provided with a bank card. A bank card can have several other names as well. It can be called a debit card, an Interact card, or an automated teller machine or ATM card. This card gives you convenient access to your account. When you first get your card, you'll be asked to choose a personal identification number or PIN. Your PIN is like an electronic signature. Choose a number that you can memorize, yet is hard for anyone else to guess. Don't use your telephone number, date of birth, address, or SIN number. As well, never write down your PIN or share it with others. When using your bank card, always protect your PIN from being seen by other people. Your financial institution may have automated teller machines at their branch. These machines are often accessible to the public 24 hours a day, so that you can do your banking when the branch is closed. The ATM will be able to take deposits, issue cash, and allow you to make bill payments and transfers between accounts. Many ATMs now offer a variety of language options. Your bank card allows you to access any ATM within your financial institution's network. The card that you use at your branch in downtown Vancouver will also work at a branch in Victoria or Prince George. You can also use another bank's ATM network to make withdrawals for a fee. This is helpful if you need cash immediately or you're traveling and do not have access to your bank's ATM network. The little icons on the back of your bank card identify which networks you can use. You may also want to check with your financial institution about which ATM networks are accessible in other countries.